Very good morning, beta. You have today your first revision test of English, and today at 5 p.m. I will be sharing the link. Why? Because most of the children are saying you are having questions at 2, at 3, at 1. So that's why we decided finally. Fine, and that link will be open for 2 hours from 5 to 7 to make it feasible for those who have questions at evening also. Clear? So. Apart from it, we cannot do anything now. Don't send me messages for that, that we can't do at 5. Clear? It is compulsory to appear up your assessment basis pe ho. So now we have characters of the chapter. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. So this is the complete name. I have written the half name here to save the time. Narrator is the protagonist. Then we have his wife, Mary. Fine. We have his son, John, or... then we have his daughter, Sue or Suzanne. John, I need to see that whether it is H-N or A-N, that we will see. Jonathan, J-O-N, I guess it will be there. Jonathan and Suzanne. So you can write J-O-N also. Claire or Suzanne. So these are the protagonists. Apart from this, we have Larry and Vigil. Larry, Vigil and one more crewman is there. Herb Siegler. These are the two crewmen who will be accompanying them on this voyage. Fine. So let me tell you some points of this. Note down. It will be very beneficial for you because a lot of data is there. On the basis of this, you can get MCQs. So when did the voyage start? In July 1976. Clear? So in July 1976, narrator... who was 37 year old. Fine, age of narrator is 37. He was 37 year old businessman. Then his wife, Mary, his 6 year old son, Jonathan. Jonathan's age is 6, you should know. Clear? 6 year old son, Jonathan, and 7 year old daughter, Mary. Oh, sorry, Sue. Fine, or Suzanne. Her full name also you should know. S-U-Z-A-N-N-E, clear? So all together, they decided to go around the world voyage just as, who was the, you can say the person behind their inspiration, you should know. They got inspired from Captain James Cook. Fine? Captain James Cook was the reason of the inspiration. They decided that if he can make it, we can also make it. So they decided to go on world voyage through the sea, this way of sea. So on the first part of their planned 3 year, they were journey was divided in parts. In the first part, 3 year planned journey it was, and the first segment was 105,000 kilometers journey, and that first segment 105,000 cleared that kilometers that passed pleasantly, happily. There were no cures, no disorders. So unka jo pehla chunk tha, that was very good. Fine. And then Larry, Vigil and American Herb Siegler. After that, they sailed down the west coast of Africa to Cape Town. Note down. After completing the first part of the journey, or underline, beta book mein aapke likha hua hai, that they sailed down the west coast of Africa to Cape Town ki taraf ho gaye. And from there onwards, in the first part of the journey, these two crewmen were not there with them. They themselves managed because the sea was not that rough. When they moved to Cape Town, then they decided to take two crewmen, Larry Vigil and Herb Siegler. Fine. Herb Siegler was a Swiss. Swiss means belonging to Switzerland. Fine. And then they decided to cross the rough southern Indian Ocean. They had to pass through the Indian Ocean or southern side. So that's why they decided that we will be taking these two crewmen with us, and Herb Siegler. Then Larry Vigil was American. You should know the nationality also. American, and he was a Swiss. क्लियर. आफ्टर दैट बेटा द सेकेंड डे आउट ऑफ केप टाउन दे फेस्ड एक्सट्रीमली स्ट्रॉन्ग विंड्स. फाइन. When it was second day to Cape Town, it was strongly wind was blowing, weather got stormy, and conditions were not that bad. But continuously for next few weeks, they faced extreme winds. Waves rose up to 15 meters, 15. The height of the waves they have mentioned 15 meters. Clear? So on 25th December. They were 3,500 kilometers east of Cape Town. By the time Christmas came, so they were 3,500 kilometers east of Cape Town. Clear? Though the weather was very bad, but even then they were very full of enthusiasm. They celebrated Christmas. They enjoyed. They had their meals also. But weather was changing from bad to worse now. Right now, on 2nd January, there were mighty waves. So you should know the dates. On 2nd Jan, mighty waves were there. Condition was worsening. They were sailing at 8 knots, K-N-O-T-S. They slowed down the boat by dropping the small sail. They tried raft drills also, in which they tried to save their lives, fine. How to wear jackets, how to jump and all. They practiced all to how to save their lives in case they are in need. Fine. And then finally, when their boats, what happened? The wind dropped. The sky immediately grew dark. Then came a growing roar and a huge wave. And finally, explosion took place. It shook the deck of their ship. And finally, narrator's head struck from with the wheel. नरेटर के हेड पे बहुत गहरी चोट लगी एंड ही फ्लू ओवर द साइड ऑफ द बोट इनटू द वाटर. ही वाज सिंकिंग बिलो द वेव्स. ही एक्सेप्टेड दैट ही इज गोइंग टू डाई. दैट वाज द सीन ऑन जनवरी 2nd. क्लियर. एंड सडनली हिज हेड अपीयर्ड फ्रॉम द वाटर फ्यू मीटर्स अवे. व्हाट वाज द नेम ऑफ द बोट इन विच दे वर डूइंग द वॉयज? Wave mast, wave walker, wave tracker, none of the above. Wave walker, right answer, Jacqueline. Fine. So you should know wave walker was the name. It was about to turn at that time, but then there was a wave which threw it upright. So due to the second wave, which was quite high, their boat wave walker took another turn and it was straight now. It did not go down into the sea. So what happened? Narrator was badly injured because he was just, you know, he was being hit into the boat just like a doll. So his left ribs cracked. His mouth was filled with blood. Then there was water everywhere on the ship. Fine, that was the situation. Suddenly his wife, Mary. Now, when narrator was badly injured, Mary came over there. She opened the door. And then what did she inform? You should know everything. She informed that they were sinking as the decks were broken. So she told the narrator that decks got broken and we are sinking now. Narrator asked her that, yes, whom did narrator ask for help to take the wheel? He asked his wife, fine, Mary, that you should handle the wheel now. Then he moved quickly to the door. Because these two people, Larry and Herb, they were madly pumping the water out of the boat. If they will not do so, they will sink into the water. So what was the job of Larry and Herb? To take the water out. So they were madly pumping water out of the ship. The wooden beams were broken. Whole starboard of the ship was bulging inwards. Clothes, kya kya bikhra pada tha wahan pe? Clothes, crockery, charts, tins, toys, everything was floating. Fine, got destroyed. So he crawled. He was not able to walk now. So narrator crawled through the cabin of his children. Fine, his son and his daughter. So at that time when he realized that they are going to die, he thought of his children. So he went to his children's room and then he noticed that his daughter Sue, 7-year-old girl, she got a big bump on her head. He did not have time to attend his daughter, though it was badly swollen, just right above her eye. but he didn't ask her well-being. He had no time. What he do there? He found a hammer, screws, canvas, and he started the repair work of the ship. Fine. Anyhow, he just double leashed everything. Water hatch covers. He started filling the gaping holes. Holes se pani andar aa raha tha. So whatever they could do, they were doing. Larry Vigil pumping the water. Mary just handling the wheel of the ship, and the narrator himself trying to repair the ship as well as putting something in the holes so that no more water could come inside. Fine. So this was the scene. And then what happened? Water level rose up dangerously. He found that there were two spare hand pumps which had been pulled away by currents along with the sail. So they wanted more hand pumps, and suddenly he realized that he had. Then he found another electric pump, connected it to an out pipe, and finally water started pumping out. Now, this all happened on 2nd January. Clear? Yes, better send me your feedback, children sitting at home. Is it clear? I'm talking about what happened on 2nd January. You should know the facts. Now, let's talk about 3rd January. On 3rd January, what happened? The pumps had reduced the amount of water on the boat. They were continuously working. Water was reduced. Each of them took rest for 2 hours. ठीक है, सबने दो दो घंटे रेस्ट किया एंड देन चेंज योर टर्न्स. दे सर्वाइव्ड. ये करते करते कितने आवर्स सर्वाइव किया? 15 आवर्स. 15. दे सर्वाइव्ड एनी हाउ एंड दे थॉट दैट देयर बोट वे वॉकर वॉज नॉट स्ट्रॉन्ग इनफ टू यू नो रीच मेक देम रीच टू ऑस्ट्रेलिया. सो दे चेक द चार्ट्स. He calculated that they found on the map that there are two islands nearby. Fine. And they have to reach, and they were just in a few hundred kilometers. They cannot go to their destination with that boat, but they could find islands over there. Fine. So which island they hoped to reach? Anyone can answer that? You remember? Which Amsterdam? Dash Amsterdam. I gave the hint only. Isle Amsterdam it was. Fine. So they hoped to reach Isle Amsterdam. It was a French scientific base only. Now, let's talk about. Yes, Aditi, right. Let's talk about now 4th January. 4th Jan, I'm talking about 4th Jan. After 36 hours of continuous pumping, they reached the last few centimeters of water. Now they had to keep pace with the water still coming in. Bahut pani bahar nikal gaya tha unhone, and they were managing. And they could not eat anything. They were so madly busy in working. So Mary finally found a beef, cornered beef. Theek hai, non-veg hai. And cracker biscuits. They ate their first meal in almost 2 days. So second, third, ko unhone kuch nahi khaya tha. They were so busy. On 4th Jan, they had their meal. Fine. Their relief was short-lived. What happened again on the 4th January at 4 p.m.? Remember 4 and 4. 4th January, 4 p.m., black clouds began building. Weather again became worse. When it was the dawn time, D-A-W-N, of the 5th Jan, early morning period, their situation was extremely dangerous. Fine, extremely dangerous. And narrator then again went to his children to comfort them. And then the title of this chapter, we are not afraid to die, we can all be together. Who said these words? Son or daughter? Yes, Jacqueline, very right. Son, Jonathan said this. And he gave comfort to his father by saying this. What did Sue does at that time? What did Sue do? She made a card and gave it to her parents. Fine. And the narrator could find no words to respond to these two gestures of kids. He got determination that yes, I will work for the sake of my children. And 22 liter plastic barrels of paraffin they found. Fine. On the morning of 6th Jan,
wind became less severe. Abhi itni severe nahi thi that they could not, you know, go further. So less severe. Situations were getting better on 6th Jan, I'm telling you. The narrator got a reading on the over there. He made quick calculations. Jaise isko reading mili, usne calculations kari ki where to reach. So finally, when they were doing at 2 p.m. after checking calculations, narrator, you know, asked Larry Vigil to steer the ship because he was so tired, and he went into the deck and he slept for continuously many hours. Fine. He was so tired. Narrator was so tired that when Larry was steering the course of 185 degrees, then they had expectations that 5 baje tak hum Isle Amsterdam pahunch jayenge. That was an estimation only. Fine. That when he dozed off, he woke up at 6 p.m. on 6th January, beta. Fine. When he woke up, his children were there to hug him, to tell him that they had reached the island. They were reached on 6th Jan there. Fine. All the dates, all the data I have discussed, you should know. Narrator rushed on deck. He saw the outline of the island of Isle Amsterdam. And next morning, all 28 inhabitants, how many inhabitants were there on the island? 28 inhabitants. Fine. They cheered them. They helped them ashore after reaching the land. Narrator thanked Larry and Vigil also. He thought of them that they were very cheerful under direst stress. Also, they helped. Fine. And finally, he thought of his 7-year-old girl who did not want him to give up or worry. He thought of his 6-year-old son also. And later on, he realized that the bump on the head of Sue was very severe. He had to go under many surgeries to get it corrected. Fine. So finally, we learn this. Okay. So you can have a quick look. Yes. Can you see the screen? Just have a look beta of the questions. From where did the ship sail for the voyage? America, Mexico, Germany, England. Yes, Dia. Any other? Yes, beta, answer though.
ये ऑप्शन पॉलीमाउथ इंग्लैंड
इट्स प्लायमाउथ इंग्लैंड फाइन इट्स नॉट पॉलीमाउथ फाइन व्हाई डिड द ऑथर डिसाइड टू गो फॉर अ राउंड द वर्ल्ड वॉयज टू डुप्लीकेट द वॉयज मेड 200 इयर्स अगो बाय कैप्टन जेम्स कुक फाइन आई एम जस्ट नॉट रिपीटिंग द ऑप्शंस ओके व्हाट वाज द ऑक्यूपेशन ऑफ द ऑथर यस अदिति
ऑप्शन ए बिजनेसमैन
Yes, right answer. He was a businessman. What was the name of the ship of the author? Waywalker. Just go through the questions. What part of the journey was pleasant for them? First leg, last part, first few months, never. Nobody is raising hand. Only Aditi and Diya are giving answers. What about others? Raise your hand. Yes, Divnur. Very good.
Then option A, first leg from England to Cape Town.
Yes, first leg was quite pleasant. What were the names of two crewmen? ये आपको first recording में भी आया था, Larry Vigil and Herb Seegler. We have just done. Fine. Why did the author hire the two crewmen to take rest, to help tackle rough sea? Because he could no longer sail. He wanted to spend some time. Yes, Divnur.
Ma'am, option B, to tackle one of the world's roughest seas, the Southern Indian.
Fine, better. Clear? So these kind of questions, dates are there. You can see waves start getting gigantic. Why did they slow down? What was the first? So these are the kind of questions. Fine, I don't want to waste time more here because you people have already asked me. Is it visible to you? Screen. बेटा आपको ब्लैक बोर्ड विजिबल है सबको? There is some problem I'm facing here, but let's see. If it is visible to you, let it be. Now I'll be telling you the brief summary of discovering the test. Aditi is a new student. She wanted it to be done now. I thought of one chapter in detail only today, but let's do it the other one also. Jitna ho sakega, I will try my level best. Okay. So we are going to do chapter discovering touch. The saga continues. Here, let it be this name only. The complete name is Discovering Tut, the saga continues. Now, saga means a story. Fine. So, you can note down some points. In this pita also, we have so many questions. 6 p.m. on 5th January 2005. Underline in your book only. Apni book saamne rakhlo aur keep underlining the facts. Mummy of Tutan Khamun moved smoothly and quietly into CT scanner, which had been carried to Tut's resting place. So who are the basic characters, main characters? King Tut, who died at very young age. Reason of his death is still unknown. That's why the name of the chapter is Discovering Tut, the saga continues. Till date, the story or saga continues because nobody knows the reason of his death. And why there were mysteries related to his death? Because when he died, he was very young. He did not have any kind of ailment. Fine. So there were chances that maybe he died under any unforeseen circumstances. So people started having speculations. Clear? About this thing only. Clear? So, first of all, the first person, the aim was to probe the medical mysteries of this young ruler. And he died 3,300 years ago. Clear? So, they were Howard Carter. So, you should know all the name. First investigator, Howard Carter. Note down or underline in your book itself. Howard Carter first recorded the pharaoh's funeral treasures. What were the funeral treasures? They believed in life after death. Fine. So whenever a person from emperor's family died, they used to, give all the things of daily use to them, like linen garments and eatables, or you can say utensils. Fine, jewelry. So they, after that, when he was the first person, Howard Carter, who was Howard Carter? He was a British archaeologist who discovered King Tut's tomb in the year 1922. Underline this data also, fine. When was King Tut's tomb discovered? In 1922, after years of futile search. So who was the one to search it? Howard Carter, a British archaeologist. Now, what were the valuables found along with this mummy? They include extremely attractive artifacts of gold, board games, bronze razor, linen undergarments, cases of food and wine. Underline this in your book. These were the things which were found along with this mummy. Carter's first recorded the pharaoh's funeral treasures. After that, after finding these valuables, he started investigating the three nested coffins. How many coffins were there? Three coffins. They were nested all together. Jud chuke the, because 3,300 years ago. It's a long time span. Fine. So when he got it, there were some sign of particular garlands of willow. Underline this. Olive trees, wild silvery, lotus petals and corn flowers. Ye sab uski shroud ke upar, coffins ke upar, they were there. So what does it show? It proves that
king Tut was buried either in the month of March or in the month of April, because these particular plants and flowers are found in these 2 months only. Clear? After that, Carter was into trouble when he reached the mummy finally. Finally, when he reached after the coffins, when he reached the mummy, the resins got hardened. His mummy was stuck with the resins and it was not easily movable. So what did he do? These had cemented to the bottom of the gold coffin. So he thought that it is very difficult to chisel them away. And what did they do? They tried to remove it. They kept it under the sun also so that it gets melted anyhow, or due to the heat, it will be easily chiseling away ho jayega, but nahi hua. Fine. Then they had to chisel it away only, and mummy was cut. Carter men removed the mummy's head. Several, chiseling was done and major joints were observed. When they finished it, they reassembled the remains again. Fine. After doing the investigation, a layer of sand in a wooden box was there. Again, they did the reassembling. Team of scientists, they found it resting there. After this investigation, nothing could be found out of it. So second person who did this investigation was Zahi Hawass. You should know all the names, beta. Fine. Zahi Hawass was the second investigator. He was Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities. He observed, he made one observation. Kya observation thi uski? He says mummy was in very bad condition because Howard Carter did badly to this mummy. So he put allegations on Howard Carter. Who put allegations? Zahi Hawass. Clear? That he had chiseled it away. Mummy is in very bad condition. So now after that, beta, unhone baat ki hai archaeology ki. Archaeology is the study of ancient things and concepts. They are saying that archaeology has changed a lot during the last few decades. Pehle archaeology mein kya hota tha? Sirf cheezon ko padha jata tha. Old things, old paintings, old antiques things, fine and all. Those antiquities were related. But now with the change in the era, it has changed a lot. Less attention to treasure. More attention to fascinating details of life and puzzling mysteries. So ab archaeology ka part hai jo details hote hain, the way you have seen in CID and forensic analysis and all, everything is part of archaeology now. Fine. So they are saying after this, this second investigator, he gave one startling fact, shocking fact. What was that? He says the breastbone and the front ribs are missing. Fine, but actually when third investigator will be doing investigation, he will say that nothing is missing. And then Howard Carter will be relieved ki okay, mere upar koi allegation nahi aaya. Fine, then after that beta, on the night of scan, when his body or mummy was taken out for the scanning, workmen were carrying its a mummy from the tomb in his box, and when they were going, and suddenly there was a change, there was climatic change from clear sky to dark sky. So people started associating some stories that some mysteries are there, King Tut's soul is there. Fine. So supernatural element, you can say. People started believing it is a rumor only or reality, nobody knows. So people started associating rumors that it is the curse of the Pharaoh. Pharaoh means king. So people started saying this is the curse of the Pharaoh, that whenever we try to take the body out of the resting place, then there is some climatic change. And then suddenly one of the fans of the city scanner, which was $1 million scanner, it stopped working, which was taken over there for the scanning. So they replaced the fan and then they did the scanning and everything was intact. Nothing was missing. Fine. So they took 1700 digital X-ray images in cross section. It was created, and 0.62 millimeter slices प्रॉपर उन्होंने उसका इन्वेस्टिगेशन किया. फाइन, कॉम्प्लिकेटेड स्ट्रक्चर वाज रेड बाय देम, फोरेंसिक्स, रेडियोलॉजी, एनाटॉमी, एंड एनाटॉमी प्रोफेसर, यू नो द पर्सन्स, यू नो इन द बायोलॉजी बायोलॉजी क्लास यू माइट हैव सीन द एनाटॉमी स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ वेरियस क्रीचर्स. सो एनाटॉमी प्रोफेसर ऑल्सो डिड द इन्वेस्टिगेशन. सो फाइनली किंग टट्स images were seen on computer screen. Gray head was there, and finally Zahi Hawass smiled. He felt relieved after that anatomy professor's investigation also, that nothing was missing. So these are the facts. Bell has gone. We have finished two chapters. At 5 o'clock exactly, you will be appearing for the test. And one more important information: those who are not attending their classes, they will not be going through the process of this registration. You're very, very casual. Especially, I have taken name again. They kindly convey to them. These are not here today also. Fine. Vansh Kapoor, be particular. Vaibhav is the most irregular. Then Arshpreet is there. Japan, you have also taken many leaves. And Jodhpreet also. Fine. These are the students who have taken maximum without informing me even. So I'm giving you the warning that kindly be regular. Otherwise, you have to face the consequences, and you will be having your listening test this week also, or maybe next week. Fine, that is part of your assessment that I will be conveying through the WhatsApp. Have a nice day.